The idea here is to heat this blade up red hot with a torch, bring these two ends together on that blade and let it melt, and then push those melted surfaces together. And that is less than an accurate way of doing this. So I want to push that through there, and we're going to melt the two ends, push it together, and then try to get it back in here. And hopefully this will hold this in much better alignment. In practice, I'm going to heat this blade with a propane torch until it's red hot. Then I will bring these close to the blade and push both ends until they melt, slide it out, get away from that hot blade, and then endeavor to shove this into my jig. Being a one-man operation, that's how we're going to do this. I'm going to keep pushing on that for about a minute. And hopefully, that aluminum jig is holding these two pieces in alignment. It's also acting as a heat sink to pull the heat out of the urethane so that joint cools off a little faster. I'm just going to let that sit for a while and cool off. That's a pretty good joint. It's aligned reasonably well. Still has a little gap over here. This flashing is sliding down on the urethane. Just peel that off. Not the prettiest joint. There's a little hole right there. This belt ended up being just a little bit too long, so I'm going to try it one more time. Actually, I may try it several more times. I'll back the camera up a little bit to get it out of my way. Having the camera in the way does not make this easier. Let that sit for a couple of minutes. Not very long, actually. That jig pulls the heat out of this pretty quick. And that looks like a much better joint. A little bit out of alignment, but it's good all the way around. I'm going to let that sit for an hour or so before I try it. But that's working quite well. This is much better than trying to do it freehand. I'm not sure what these two pieces of aluminum or aluminium were in their first life. They may have been a heat sink. I pried them off of something. They had been pinned to something. And they were tapped for a 3mm thread. I drilled these out on this side so they would pass through there freely. I can screw them together. The belting I'm using is 1/4 inch outside diameter. I drilled this hole through here, 1/4 inch. It's a little bit too snug, so I opened that up to the next fractional drill size, which is 17/64. And that leaves a little bit of wiggle room in there for that urethane belt, and when you melt the two ends, it gives some place for that excess material to flow. If you haven't done one of these for a while, it will take a little experimentation to get back up to speed. I want to keep a few pieces of scrap urethane and practice doing your joints. When you heat this up red hot, that looks like it's way too hot, but this cools off pretty quick. And so when I get up here and get ready to melt that, that only stays hot enough to melt this for a few seconds. And then if I have to come back and do it again, I got to reheat the blade. So having something a little bit heavier than this wouldn't hurt. And then you get some urethane on here and it drips down and get down on your surface. I put something under here to catch that. And once it burns off, you can move that out of the way. And what I have found, if I melt these and don't try to push and pull at the same speed, bring this one over here and use this to push that through there and then hold back with this side. And that seems to result in a better joint. And I like to hold this for about 1 minute. And I'm putting pressure on both sides. Primarily, I was pushing on this side and holding back with this a little bit to force that into the jig and hold that together for about a minute. And I'm going to let that cool off. I like the way the edge of the jig pushes that flashing away from the joint. It makes this real easy to clean up. And that's a good joint. Alignment's not too bad, and there aren't any holes in the edge. This is a rewind belt for the Oregon, and I tried that, and that's on there. It's a good strong joint.